I love my pizza as much as the next girl, and it totally counts as a vegetable, right? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. It wasn't that long ago when the US Congress declared pizza as a source of some of your daily vegetable intake. The bill proposed back in 2011 allowed the USDA to count 2 tablespoons of tomato paste as a vegetable. But as bad as that sounds, that's exactly how most Americans are getting their vegetables. So the thing is, the USDA recommends that we eat about 2.5 to 3 cups of vegetables a day. But a recent survey from the Centers for Disease Control found that 87% of adults don't get that much. Instead, the vegetables we do eat, like tomatoes and potatoes, are in the form of processed foods like French fries and tomato paste on pizza. But even if things change now and people start eating healthy, there's a bigger problem. There's simply not enough veggies to go around. Recently, the USDA found that only 1.7 cups of veggies are available for every person, and not even the kind that's recommended. Daily recommendations promote a variety of veggies, from dark leafy greens to colorful veggies to tasty legumes. A recent report by the USDA found that potatoes, tomatoes, and lettuce make up close to 60% of US vegetable availability. Unfortunately, most of those produce are set for processing into less healthy foods like potato chips and tomato sauces. So what are farmers growing instead of produce? Well, the top 5 most common crops in America are corn, soybeans, hay, wheat, and cotton. Of the 300 million acres of farmland used for food, only a small portion, 14 million acres, are used for fruits and veggies. And that includes the stuff we grow for processed foods like chips. And they aren't growing these crops to meet demands of American appetites. A lot of it has less to do with the nation's food habits and more to do with price. The federal government heavily subsidizes crops like corn, which might be good for the food supply, except for most of it doesn't get eaten by people. According to the National Corn Growers Association, about 80% of all corn grown in the US is consumed by domestic and overseas livestock, poultry, and fish production. Only 12% of corn is consumed directly or indirectly as corn syrup for things like soda. Farmers grow whatever crops are the most profitable, and that doesn't always mean food. Like in 2011, a lot of southern farmers switched from growing food to growing cotton as the price of cotton soared. Webb Wallace, executive director of the Cotton and Grain Producers of the Lower Rio Grande Valley, said, "It's good for the farmer, but from a humanitarian perspective, it's kind of scary." Well, this isn't new. Americans have always prized profit over produce. Some of the earliest settlers grew crops like tobacco that they could sell rather than food they could survive on. As a result, well, a lot of people starved. So it's clear our agricultural system needs a bit of an overhaul. And we could do our part by demanding more yummy veggies. And thankfully, veggies are becoming trendy. One of the most popular leafy greens of late is kale. How did kale become such a super veg, and just how good for you is it? Check out this video to find out more. In terms of nutrient density, other leafy greens like chicory and Chinese cabbage bested the super popular superfood. The popular green placed a paltry 15th. So the question is, what veggies are your favorite? I'm a bit of a weirdo and really love Brussels sprouts. Tell us down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.